Frutabela spodbuja dobre navade.
Riding or driving, feel confident with Continental.
Cestno kolo von Driest, 2959,99 €. Hervis.
Lep pozdrav in dobrodošli na I Feel Slovenia virtualni dirki po Sloveniji. Hello and welcome at the I Feel Slovenia virtual tour of Slovenia. Tole danes je druga etapa, ki poteka od Črnomlja do Novega mesta. This today is a second stage which takes place from Črnomelj to Novo mesto. Zakaj komentiram v angleščini in slovenščini? Ja, ker se dirke udeležujejo tudi tekmovalci iz celega sveta, zato je komentiranje dvojezično. Because the participants came from all over the globe, the commentary is bilingual. Kdo bo danes z nami? Danes bosta z nami ultrakolesar Marko Baloh in pa profesionalni kolesar Jani Brajkovič. Če naredim povzetek prejšnje etape, je torej na prvi etapi virtualne dirke po Sloveniji, I Feel Slovenia virtualne dirke po Sloveniji, kar 434 tekmovalcev iz 44 držav tekmovalo, participiralo. At the first stage of I Feel Slovenia virtual tour of Slovenia, there was 434 competitors from 44 countries. Ja, na vrhu krvavca je bil prvi Nemec Julian Stefens, med Slovenci pa je odlično 13. mesto skupno zavzela Lara Rajterič, 19-letna Lara, bravo. So yes, Julian Stefens was first at the top of Krvavec Climb, and the best Slovenian was Lara Rajterič at the great 13th place. Poglejmo, kaj pravijo številke danes. Danes je število prijavljenih podobno, 440 vas je oziroma vas bo. Prihajate iz 43 držav, najbolj številne države po udeležencih pa so dosti podobne kot zadnjič, torej Združene države Amerike, na drugem mestu Slovenija, kasneje Češka, potem Velika Britanija, Nemčija in Poljska. Yeah, let's see what the numbers of participants are saying today. 440 number of participants from 43 countries, and the majority of participants are from USA, Slovenia, Czech Republic, Great Britain, Germany and Poland. Torej, tako kot sem že rekel, druga etapa od Črnomlja do Novega mesta, 42 km, je dolga, ja, pa poglejmo oziroma predstavimo profesionalnega kolesarja, s katerim boste lahko danes kolesarili. Jani Brajkovič je tole, leta 2012 je slavil z zmago na dirki po Sloveniji. Enakega leta je bil tudi deveti na dirki po Franciji. Je pa leta 2004 postal time trial champion, torej prvak v kronometru, svetovni prvak v kronometru v kategoriji U23. Jaz predlagam, da ga kar pozdravimo. Jani, se slišimo. Halo, Jani, se slišimo.
Živja. Ja.
Živja, pozdravljen. Ko sem pregledoval tvoje rezultate leta 2012, zmaga na dirki po Sloveniji, kako ti je ostala v spominu?
Ja, zelo lepa dirka, tudi samo leto je bilo zelo, zelo uspešno. Dirka je bila pred turom, tako da sem prišel pripravljen in sem uspel zmagati, tako da zelo lepi spomini.
Ja, ko si omenil tur, tudi jaz, ko sem te napovedal, kasneje 9. mesto na dirki po Franciji, bom tako rekel, si takrat predstavljal, da bomo imeli Slovenca na prvem in drugem mestu, torej na zmagovalnem odru, kar dva Slovenca, kdaj na dirki po Franciji?
Ja, predstavljal si nisem, upal pa sem.
Upal pa si, odlično, odlično. Ja, ko sem v bistvu gledal tvoje rezultate, so nekako prevladovale enotedenske dirke. Zdaj, če sem prav zasledil, tudi nikoli nisi odvozil Strade Bianche, ki je ravno danes potekala. Imam pravilne informacije.
Ja, tako je, nikoli nisem vozil te dirke.
Pa resnici, kaj ne?
Tako je, čeprav proti koncu karijere sem imel željo dirkati, ampak se ni nekako išlo.
Tudi spremenil se je stil dirkanja na Strade Bianche. Tudi ni več recimo tako pomembno, da bi bil dober kot za klasike, kaj ne? Tudi lažji kolesarji ima zdaj kar nekaj več možnosti za zmago.
Ja, tako je. Če pogledamo današnje rezultate, se tudi vidi, da lahko kolesari za etapne dirke zelo dobro dirkajo. Tako da ja, nekako se je samo dirkanje spremenilo, dirka mogoče malce spremenila, pa tudi sama pomembnost dirke je zelo večja, veliko večja, kot je bila nekaj let nazaj.
Ok. Ja, en kratek pogovor o trasi današnji. Koliko krat si se recimo ti peljal od Črnomlja do Novega mesta? Kako jo imaš ti v spominu te ceste?
Ja, lahko rečem, da verjetno vsaj 200 krat na leto.
Vsaj 200 krat na leto, ok, ok.
Ja, zmenjeno. Tako da zelo dobro poznam to traso.
Odlično, odlično. Jani, kasneje se bova še slišala. Najlepša hvala za sedaj. Zdaj pa imam tukaj tudi Marka Baloha, ultrakolesarja. Marko.
Živo.
Živo, pozdravljam.
Se slišmo.
Kako smo?
Ok. V redu.
Ravno kar
Tako je. Tako da dan sem pripričal, da se tlele pridružim, bom bolj za užitek. Pa pomalo se razterati, tako da ne pričakujete kakih velikih vatov od mene.
Kaj pa ti, kako se pa ti spomniš, mogoče, koliko krat si se peljal od Črnomlja do Novega mesta? Se spomniš kakšnih teh cest?
Ja, vse, jaz sem pa priženjen, tako rekoč, blizu Novega mesta. Tako da je bilo nekaj let, ko smo kar veliko preživeli tam. Tako da, mislim, precejkrat, no, ne pa to, kar kaj vsem treba čez Gorjance zlezi, da priješ tja.
Res je.
Pa vredno to daj na kakaj dirki, no, bo tudi tam čez plezal.
Superca. Ja, in ravno čez nekaj sekund si bomo lahko pogledali traso, ki nas čaka danes. Trasa je dolga dobrih 42 km, poprečen naklon, ki je izmerjen je 2%, z maksimalnim naklonom 10%. Torej, tako kot je že Marko omenil, je treba zlesti čez Gorjance. Prvi del trase je dokaj ravninski, po pokrajini Bele krajine. Kasneje, na 19. kilometru, pa se začne trasa dvigovati proti Gorjancev. So yes, as Marko was saying, today's stage takes place from Črnomelj to Novo mesto. It is 42 kilometers in length. The first part of the stage is flat on Bela Krajina region, which is also the birthplace of the Jani Brajković. It's then followed by a 10 kilometers ascent to Gorjanci hills, and then the descent towards Novo mesto, and that is the traditional place where the last stage of Tour of Slovenia ends. Ja, sedaj pa samo še počakamo na štart, ki bo čez dobre 3 minute. Ogromno vas je. Marko, se kako posebej ogreješ? Koliko imaš recimo izkušenj z virtualnim kolesarjenjem?
Ja, kar nekaj sem Na Zwiftu mislim, da je že kar dobro to leto, zdaj 3,5. Ja, te so te dirke so specifične, po mojem nekaj podobnega, kot da bi ciklokrosa pa mountain bike od štarta do daske, pokrvato lahko stisneš iz sebe, tako da ostaneš pred sporo grupo. Mislim, tako če hočeš resno dirka, da ne, ali pa dosežeš rezultat. Tako se treba fajno gledati, no.
Tako je, ja.
Pa tudi, če se odzuni, recimo, zakačem, koliko je danes, 40 km, to bi rekel, en kronometer tak malo daljši, ne. Tudi potrebuje kar precejšnje ogrevanje. Jaz običajno sem kako uro porabil za ogret se, teda kronometer hud.
Ok, ok. Ja, da ne pozabim omeniti, trasa bo seveda ostala na ROUVY, na ROUVY platformi, tako da jo v bistvu lahko, če kasneje gledate tale video, brez kakršnekoli težave odpeljete. So yes, this stage will stay at the ROUVY platform. That means you can ride it every time you want. So yeah, try it out. Tako, dobivam pa ravno zadnje podatke, torej 467 vas je že prijavljenih. Tako da ja, številke kar rastejo. Upam, da bodo rastle tudi številke vato na kilogram in da bomo videli kakšne zavidljive rezultate. Marko, kako si se pripravljal? Ja, zdaj na Tenerifih po 2 tednih, nekako je potem kar težko sest za računalnik v virtualni svet, verjamem, ko si navajen letih izgledal.
Ja, težko je bilo že vrniti se včeraj, veš, smo v Bergamo pa z avtom in pol čez mejo je začeli snežiti, tako da smo se pravili po avtocesti 60 na uro, prav snežni meter, tako da smo se spogledali, smo rekli, da nismo še kakšen teden podaljšali. Veš, kaj je bilo fino, v bistvu en let smo bili brez, da bi kam leteli lanskrat, ko smo svrnili z kanalskih, tih en tak čas, je bilo pol konc svega, ne, tako da je bilo res zadnji čas, da smo šli malo živčke, prostiti pa res je bilo lepo, no. Priporočam kanalske za kolesarski trening izmeri, tako čas po mladi ali pa po zimi, super je.
Tako, dobre pol minute je, kolikor vidim, še do štarta, torej druge etape, I feel Slovenia, virtualne dirke po Sloveniji. So yes, it is 30 seconds until the start of I feel Slovenia, virtual tour of Slovenia. It's the second stage, which takes place from Črnomelj to Novo mesto. Ja, jaz želim v bistvu obema, da vam bo, bom tako rekel, čim lažje pri kolesarji do cilja, da boste brez težav od kolesarla. Takole, 3, 2, 1 in gremo, pa da vidimo. Takole, naj na tem mestu štarta omenim, da Frutabela, sponzor virtualne dirke po Sloveniji, I feel Slovenija, virtualne dirke po Sloveniji. Po vsaki etapi na svoji spletni strani predstavi nekatere zanimive podatke o profesionalnih kolesarjih, ki se nam oziroma vam pridružijo pri kolesarjenju. In ja, med 8. in 12. marcem se bo lahko na spletni strani sodelovalo v nagradni igri, v kateri je potrebno napovedati, koliko kalorij bo v tretji etapi, ki bo dolga 39 km, porabil profesionalni kolesar. Kaj so nagrade? Nagrade so 5 kolesarskih paketov, v enem paketu pa je cela škatla frutabel in pa bidon ekipe Bahrain Victorious, tako da verjamem, da se splača sodelovati in ugibati, koliko kalorij bo profesionalni kolesar porabil. Zdaj, ja, recimo Matej je na prejšnji etapi porabil 218 kalorij in dosegel maksimalno hitrost skoraj 50 km na uro. Ok, poglejmo, kaj se dogaja na dirki. Zdaj, samo trenutek, da najdem. Ja. Prva mesta se kar menjavajo. Tako da je težko karkoli reči. Moramo še malenkost počakati, da vidimo, kako se bo dirka dejansko razvila čez nekaj minut. Jaz bom pa tole kar izkoristil, da morda pogledamo, kako gre Janjo. pa da vidimo. Jani, ali se slišimo?
Ja.
Ja, kako gre? Kako gre? So že ogreta pljuča.
Ja. Ne, niso še.
Niso še.
Ne.
Niso še. Vidim, da pritiskaš na pedala kar v zavidljivih številkah. Koliko imaš
ja,
ti,
za
recimo...
Ja,
zaenkrat še. Koliko imaš pa recimo ti izkušenj z virtualnim kolesarjenjem?
S kolesarjenjem veliko, s dirkanjem pa nič. Se pravi, virtualno kar veliko kolesarjem, dirk se pa ne udeležuje.
Okay. So Jani, tell me, how much of a virtual racing did you take place? Do you have a lot of experience with virtual racing or not?
No, I haven't done a lot of racing. I did a lot of training on different platforms, but racing very little.
Okay. Kako recimo boš razporedil, bom tako temu rekel, moči danes? Vemo, da v virtualnem kolesarjenju, oziroma večkrat smo že povedali, da gre bolj kot ne kar cel čas na nož, torej na polno, ampak vseeno malenkost se je treba, po angleško je beseda pacing, torej treba se pesati, da se ne prekuriš prehitro. Boš imel to v mislih?
Ja, jaz pač vem, ko grem lahko in to bom šel. Kam je pa to pripeljalo, pa ne vem, ne.
Pa poglejmo še, kako gre Marko tu. Marko, se slišimo?
Se slišimo.
Se slišimo? Kako
se slišimo,
je?
Ja.
Ja. Že kaj teže dihamo.
Ja, mečkem res. Mate se zmer glupo potegne, veš, čeprav sem rekel, da ne bom lih pritisku. Tako da sem nekje v zlati sredini. Za enkrat do konca bomo videli, kako. Nisem pa še glupo rovija, no, to je danes prvič. Tako da prvič vidim, kako to zgleda. To je real life video pa avatari. Risanka, ne, tako da je zanimivo.
Res je, res je. So yeah, Marko, tell me, how will you pace yourself today? Will you try to hold until the climb or just full gas all time?
Now, yeah, like I told you, I'm a bit tired after the camp, so my goal was to ride around 3 to 3.5 watts per kilo, which is doable for me. For those, this hour or so. So I'm going to stick to that, more or less.
So
not
yeah,
more than 3.5,
as an ultra cyclist, how do you spend time on a turbo trainer? I don't know, for 12 hours. I know that you hosted an event, charity rides, 24 hours and longer. How yeah. do you sit still and pedal?
Yeah, well, yes, usually the seat can be a problem. Not with me anymore. Now for years I've been using Infinity bike seat, which really relieves the pressure. So that's not a problem anymore. Otherwise, yeah, I have to keep on adding nutrition, hydration. That's especially important inside because you lose a lot of sweat. And for those long rides, it's just, I don't know, boring, you know, on the computer. So for that event that you mentioned, there was always people joining me I mean, in real life, they came to the spinning bikes beside me. So that was pretty awesome. And, you know, the time moves by a lot faster. If you're all alone in the basement like this, yeah, that can be pretty tough, you know, to spend 10 or 12 hours in the basement by yourself.
Yeah, yeah. I understand. Ja, si tudi ambasador blagovne znamke Hervis, ki je sponsor današnje etape. Pa mi povej, v bistvu, kako je v bistvu, recimo sodelovati z takšno blagovno znamko? Koliko recimo tebi to pomaga pri uresničevanju vseh tvojih podvigov?
Ja, mislim, zdaj vemo, kako je s temi dirkami brez sponzorjev. Ne bi šlo nekaj tvar zadeve, koštajo. Tako da se mogli se najbolj zahvaliti. Najprej Hervisu, ki smo danes tele povabili. Pa tudi sem ostalim sponzorjem, ker brez njih pač ne bi šlo. Tudi priprave, dirke, nažalost se konča in z tega tudi moramo malo razmišljati velikrat, kateri dirk se držiti, ker nimamo računa čisto vse. Ampak tako je, no. Pa da Hervis pa poleg tega, no, tudi še pomaga s kako kolesarsko primo, čelade, zdaj še nekaj časa vozem Alpina, ki jih uvaže, tako da ta zadeva recimo mi zelo ustreza. Sem zelo zadovoljen, da so se odločili na podprejo, tako da najlepša hvala jim.
Odlično. Superca. Zdaj, ja, kot sva že večkrat rekla, bil si na pripravah na Tenerifih. Letos se bo zgodil odhod na Red Bull Trans-Siberian Extreme. Lani je, žal, vsi vemo, zaradi situacije bil odpovedan. Nekako si tudi ti za letos še vedno skeptičen, ampak vseeno, ja, mogoče, če na kratko razložiš, kaj te v bistvu sploh tam čaka?
Ja, to je dirka Red Bull Trans-Siberian Extreme, se pravi od Moskve do Vladivostoka. 9200 km, zapravo je še skoraj dvakrat daljša, kot res okrog Amerika. Ena zadeva, ki pa bolj življenjska, pa bolj meni pisana na kožo, je pa ta, da ni tisto, da se štoparca štarta na začetku, pol pa se ne ostavi do konca, zapravo ni spanja, tukaj to na ramo. Tukaj gre pa za etape, no. V bistvu etapna dirka, 15 etap, dolge sicer od 300 do 1400 km, ampak vmes si pa ti lahko v hotelu, se ne spiš, dobiš masažo, tako da zadeva je nekaj bolj podobna tej klasični etapni dirki. Tak lep cilj, no. Moram reči, sem spremljal ta dirka, je bila že, mislim, da zdaj bo šesta, no. Sem že kar nekaj let spremljal, ker mi je tak velik izziv, da sem bil zelo vesel, da sem ga povabil. Zraven tako da, letos je v planu, to pa ste rekel pa, da sem skeptičen, v bistvu, to je ti strah, veš. Lani smo marci začeli s tem covidom, pa smo si govorili, da se bo maja boj derke, pa juni, juli, in bo šel let mimi, ni bilo v bistvu skoraj nad zarasno. Personalce, hvala Bogu, je bilo, ne? Da smo lahko navijali za Primože in Andreje in vse ostale. Ampak tako, z tega razloga pa krivim, kakaj je situacija. Pač jaz nisem pripričan, da organizatorji nam kar pošiljajo vsake tog časa spodbudne mele, da se je v redu, rusko ministrstvo sodeluje, ni problemov, ampak dokler ne bomo v Moskvi tam, mislim, da 18. junija, pač bom večkrat skeptičen, ker nikoli ne veš, kaj se lahko zalom na poti do tja. Upamo najboljši.
Res je.
Vsekako pa imamo plan, tudi če slučajno ne bi bilo letos, sem siguren, da bo drug let, tako da ustrajamo.
Tako je, če ne letos, pa drug leto. Kaj pa dirka po Sloveniji? Kako se recimo ti spominjaš od svojih začetkov, bom tako rekel, no?
Ja, zelo dobro. Jaz sem bil že na prvi zraven. Mislim, da takrat še Jani, se zlagal, vjetni više mladince, ali pa mogoče ni kolesar. 33. leta.
93, kar res je.
Ja, tukaj sem vozil z krko, dober, moja, specialno so bili kronometri, da sem je napaljen ful za prolog v Novom mestu. In sem prišel precej bliz, a ne vem, če je bilo, moj na manjka 10 sekund. Vse se je zasekiralo, ko sem v bistvu na štartu, zamočil pa sem štartal na tamali šajbi. Preden sem mesto po gruntu, se kaj tako vrtim, pa da lahko vidi tudi 5, 6, 7 sekund mi tam ušlo, ne. A dobro, pravi posebna izkušnja. A še na konc, mislim, da smo zmagali. Imaš ti kakaj rezultat, a je Glivar zmagal tisto leto. Ne, Primožič. En čas nisem razumel. No, češ pogleda. Vrla, ne bilo je dobro, ker bo glasno kar nekaj tako so fantje, no. Ja, ampak jaz pa tist čist moj cilj, no. A da nekaj kilometr se na stopničke prišel, pa ni. Uspel mi se sem v četrti, pa peti. Eno majte sem dubil, no. Ampak ne tisto, ko sem se jo želil.
Ja, Boris Premožič je leta 93 zmagal na dirki po Sloveniji iz Roga.
Vlasto kar bliz, mislim, da je bilo. Da so bonifikacije odločile, da je bilo na knap par sekund, ampak ja, je pa lepa. Pač, smo bili veseli, da se je začela dirka, ne. Mi so prej, pred tem, po let, nekaj leti bilo noč, pred tem smo imeli Alpe Adrio, Slovence, ne. To je bila neka predhodnica, s tem, da je dirka te etape so šli tudi v Avstrijo, po Italijo, a seveda, Jugoslavijo, ne. To pa nažalost vozil sem enkrat, pa bi se želel večkrat, ampak nekako nisem prišel zraven takrat.
Okay. So yes, Jani is putting a great watts on his pedals. He is currently at the sixth place. Yeah, he's, as we say, flying. The first 10 of participants are on the 10th kilometer of the race. So in approximately 9 kilometers there will be this false flat uphill section to Gorjanci. But yeah, Marko, tell me, how do you remember Tour of Slovenia? You were there from the start, as you said.
Yeah, it was a nice race for us Slovenians. You know, after Yugoslavia split up, we didn't have any more Tour de Yugoslavia and Alpe Adria. So we were really happy to have the race. In fact, my club at the time, Krka, Novo Mesto was organizing. So we were all fired up to try to win. I did a pretty good prologue, not my best because I messed up a little something at the start, so I lost, I think, less than 10 seconds. It was a short one, 4 or 5 kilometers. Anyways, and at the end, our guy, Srečko, was fighting for the victory, but he ended up in second place by a few seconds. So it was not perfect. We did take some stages. I mean, our guys, sprinters, but we didn't take the overall win, so weren't really 100% happy, but I mean, we were happy to have the race, the stage race again in Slovenia, so it's good memories. It's a long time ago, 28 years.
That's
cool. Couldn't believe it.
Yeah. Da dam Janju in Marku malenkost predaha, bom napovedal tudi kontinental, ki je v bistvu uradna pneumatika dirke po Sloveniji, tudi uradna pneumatika iFeel Slovenija virtualne dirke po Sloveniji. Torej podarjajo 5 parov kolesarskih pneumatik Grand Prix 5000, torej pneumatike za cestna kolesa. Continental, the official tire of iFeel Slovenia Virtual Tour of Slovenia, will give 5 pairs of Grand Prix 5000 tires in their competition. Ja, en par pneumatik se bo podelil v nagradni igri v tistem tednu med tretjo in četrto etapo. Nagradno vprašanje pa bo seveda objavljeno na socialnih omrežjih dirke po Sloveniji, torej na Facebooku in Instagramu. One pair of tires will be given out between third and the fourth stage and the prize question will be published on social profile of Tour of Slovenia at Facebook and Instagram. Tukaj zdaj pa lahko vidimo, da tekmovalci oziroma kolesarji že prihajajo skozi prvi hotspot. Split čas, torej tisti vmesni čas bo na vrhu hriba, torej na vrhu Gorjancev, če imam pravilne informacije na 27. kilometru. Tamle se bo morda že videlo, kdo bodo tisti, ki se bodo potegovali za prvo mesto ali pa za prvo deseterico. Trenutno pa Janiju kaže zelo dobro, na petem mestu je. Ja, fant je, kako bi rekel, letijo, skoraj 50 km na uro je hitrost. Tako da ja, predlagam, da morda pogledamo v Pain Cave Janija Brajkoviča. Jani, si z nami.
Ja.
Odlično ti gre na šestem mestu.
Ja, to je zdaj zelo relativno.
So yeah, the breath is more vivid. How is it going? You're as we say, flying. You're putting 6+ watts per kilo. How are you feeling? Will it go till the end?
I will go to the end, but I have no idea how fast.
Ok, tukaj zdaj na tem kratkem klančku pa si takoj napredoval za dve mesti. Morda bi se moral večkrat vključiti v pogovor s tabo. Morda to pomaga. Ha?
Ja, ampak zdaj nadol bom pa 3 zgubil.
Boš pa 3 zgubil, ok. Superca. Jani, ja. Takrat, ko si leta 2004 vzel titulo zmagovalca tistega kronometra v kategoriji U23, sicer je najbolj klišej vprašanje, ampak vseeno, kakšni so bili občutki do takrat kakšnih takšnih rezultatov vseeno nismo bili vajeni?
Občutko ni bilo, če sem iskren, ker se nisem zavedal, kaj to pomeni. Zelo velik, kar nekaj let se nisem zavedal, kaj sem dosegel. Tako da takrat nisem pravzaprav čutil nič, ker moj cilj je bil zmeraj World Tour in dirkat v World Touru. In tisto svetovno je bil samo en korak do World Toura.
In nekako se ti je potem poklopilo ravno to, da si kasneje prestopil v World Tour. Kaj pa za naprej? Sedaj po bom rekel, skoraj polnoletni karieri. Kakšni so plani za naprej? Kakšne so želje?
Plano je velik, opcij je tudi velik, tako da želim se stati v kolesarstvu kot trener, kot mentor kolesarjem in pravzaprav to se tudi zdaj že počas dogaja. Treniram nekaj kolesarjev, nekaj mladih, nekaj starejših. Pojavlja se pa še ena opcija za trenerja ekipe. Tako da, to je to.
Vidim na tvojih socialnih omrežjih, da si nekako razpet med Dubajem in Slovenijo. Ali govoriva sedaj o tem, da bi ostal v Sloveniji in tukaj treniral kakšno ekipo ali vseeno v Združenih Arabskih Emiratih?
Pravzaprav je zadeva v Abu Dhabi, ne v Dubaju, tako da ja, vseeno v Emiratih. Ja.
No, pa vseeno nisi izgubil mest, kolikor te lahko spremljam tukaj na aplikaciji. No, si vseeno ohranil četrto mesto, tako da imaš super izhodišče za tisti vzpon na Gorjance.
Ja, ampak ne vem, koliko mi je še ostalo. Sem trenutno kar na limitu, tako da bomo videli.
No, pa še jaz te tukaj sprašujem stvari. Se slišiva čez nekaj minut, no. Dobro, kolesari še naprej, pa se slišiva čez nekaj minut, ja.
Tako.
Ok, so let's see what the Marco has got to say. Marco, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah.
I'm here.
Yeah, so how is it going? I mean, you are putting some watts in your pedals, but you said this was just a recovery ride.
Yeah, well,
does this look like a recovery to you?
it's a little bit harder to recover, yeah. I mean, when the road rises a little bit, I do push on the pedals, especially if I'm with a group. I try to stay with them. But yeah, on the total, it won't be too taxing, I don't think. It won't be a total recovery, but a nice tempo ride.
Ja, Marko, zdaj, ko se pogovarjava, v bistvu, kako se recimo pripraviš na neko ultra izkušnjo, na ultra kolesarjenje, ki, tako kot si prej rekel, vzame cirka 5000 kilometrov. Kako treniraš za kaj takega?
Se ni kratki odgovor ali na to, ne? Tako čisto... Bazična osnova treninga je dost podobna, da rečem ista, kot za dirkače, profije. Tako da skušaš delati malo na moči, malo hitrosti, intervale, tega da imaš to čim višji iz anaerobni prag. Čeprav mi ultraše bo ravno aerobnega, ampak čim višjega mačunga, nek mi trej se lahko špeleš bolj aerobno. Ne. Tako da, poleg tega, možeš pa se dodajati dolge vožnje. To pa, od začetka smo tam mogli, da sem bil recimo prvi sklodin, ker sem se tega malo lopil, 40 ur pa to. Možeš kar precej dela tega, no, šprav, vožen 12 ur pa 15, 16, pa tudi 24, zdaj pa tudi daljše. Ampak z leti pa nekak, pa s temi dirkami, ko sem jih že odpelil, je pa tega malo manj treba, no. Tako da, sitno se zmer, seveda dolgi treningi so, ampak recimo, da več kot 10-12 ur, pa za trening ni več potrebno, no. Za mene osebno.
Okay.
Tako, no. Pa če to ne, stalno meni sprašujejo, kako lahko cel leto delaš, v bistvu, po zimi pač. Ni razen, če kakaj telka bo, no, pač dobrodelna, zadeva 14 urna, je bilo pač bolj zaradi tega eventa, ampak drugič pa sami treningi pa po zim, kaj več kot 6-7 ur. Ne, no, pa že to je veliko, tako je virtualno, ne. Dobro pa, v starih časih, se prav pred COVID-om je bilo fino, ker iz Ljubljane se vsedeš v avto, pa se zapeleš na Primorsk, se tam lahko več ali normalno peleš, pač malo bolj se oblečeš še, ne vem, 5-6 stopin, ampak tega nažalost letos nismo mogli zaradi lockdowna, zaradi covida, pač malo več virtualnega. Se znajdemo.
Super, super. So yeah, Marco, tell me, how do you prepare yourself for such an ultra event like 5,000 kilometers? Some would say that the average speeds won't be so high, but they are really high. They are around 30 kilometers per hour. As I was watching some statistics.
Yeah, well, I ran probably in the last days, if not anymore. An hour even for Jure Robic, who won the race five times. But yeah, let's say for 24 hours, if you want to win the race or set the record, which I did a couple of times, I think my average was 7 kilometers an hour. Nowadays, some younger guys go even faster, like Strasser, he did 39 almost on the marathon for 24 hours, which is pretty crazy if you think about it. Try to sit on the bike, go, I don't know, 38 kilometers an hour for 10 minutes, and you see that it's hard. At the training, the basics are basically the same as for, you know, normal or racers or professionals. So you try to work on your power and your speed also. And it's also more fun, you know, if you just be grinding down the miles, it becomes boring. So it's more interesting, and also you improve your anaerobic threshold, which means that you can ride at higher speed aerobically. And that is the goal. Kind of. So, and other than that, you just have to add the long rides in the week. And those long rides can be kind of 5-6. Nowadays, for me, up to 12 hours, because I don't need any more simulations. I did so many races of 24 hours in the day or two, or 8 or 9 for REM. So, and that's it. And other than that, it's all a lot, depends on nutrition. So you also have to train your stomach body, I don't know, to be able to absorb calories, which you need, the hydration. So it's a lot of factors, and the experience helps a lot. So that's why at my age, 50 plus, I can still be competitive.
It's great. That's great.
Somewhat.
yeah, thank you, Marco. If I'm correct, now will be the time for the commercials. So yeah, we'll hear from each other after this commercial break. And Jani is great. He's doing great. He's on the third spot. He's on the 12th kilometer. So yeah, as the race unfolds, now they are climbing towards the Gorjanci hill. So yeah, and the great Jani took over to second place. He's putting 6 watts per kilo in his pedals. So yeah, that means he's really flying on this hill.
Frutabela spodbuja dobre navade.
Riding or driving. Feel confident with Continental.
Fondrist
2,999.95
Pozdravljeni nazaj na iFeel Slovenija virtualni dirki po Sloveniji. Tole je druga etapa, ki poteka od Črnomlja do Novega mesta. Hello again at the iFeel Slovenia virtual tour of Slovenia. This is a second stage which takes place from Črnomelj to Novo mesto. Če pogledamo, Jani Brajković je še vedno na super tretjem mestu. Pa da naredimo nekako ponovno opis etape, da vidimo, kje se sploh, s kakšnimi cestami se spopadajo danes kolesarji. Torej, 42 km, dobrih 42 km je dolga trasa. Maksimalni naklon je cirka 10%, to so sicer tisti krajši vmesni. Prvi del trase, ki so ga kolesarji po večini že prevozili, je ravninski del po pokrajini Bele krajine. To je tudi kraj rojstva Janija Brajkoviča, našega profesionalnega kolesarja, ki se nam je danes pridružil. Kasneje, na 19. kilometru, pa so se pričeli kolesarji dvigovati proti Gorjancem. Nekako dobrih 10 kilometrov tega klanca oziroma tega vzpona jih čaka. Konec trase v Novem mestu, kjer se pa tradicionalno konča zadnja etapa dirke po Sloveniji. So yes, today's stage, as I said, takes place from Črnomelj to Novo mesto, and distance is 42 kilometers, and the maximum gradient is 10% on some parts. The first part of the stage is flat in the Bela krajina region, which is also the birthplace of the cycling ace Jani Brajković, who is cycling right now, and it's on the second place. It's then followed by a 10 kilometers ascent to Gorjanci Hills, which is, yeah, not overly demanding, but it is hard if you go all out. Then it's descent towards Novo mesto, which is not technically demanding either. And the stage finishes in Novo mesto, as in Novo mesto main square, the traditional place where the last stage of Tour of Slovenia race ends. Če poskusimo ujeti Janija z nekaj besedami, da vidimo, kako mu kaže. Prej je rekel, da je skoraj na koncu z močmi. Jani, kako je sedaj? Sedaj si nekje na slabi polovici tega vzpona. Še vedno ti zelo dobro kaže, na drugem mestu si.
Ja, kar v redu.
So yeah, Jani, tell me, how are you feeling? You are at the half part of the ascent. Do you think it will go like that to the end?
I think I can do 6 watts per kilo.
Okay.
From the top. And yeah, that's pretty much it. And then we'll see what happens on the descent. Because what I've noticed is that because of my light weight, I get dropped, even if I'm drafting. So we'll see.
We'll see. That's great. That's great. Thank you for now. Thank you for now.
Sure.
Marco. Marco, how is it going in your place?
Oh, well, still pushing around 3.5 watts per kilo. I have a nice virtual group around. I don't know, pretty good. I'm enjoying the video, actually. It's been a couple of years since I've been riding towards Vachta Pass on this road, so I like to remember the old times when I did this.
That's great. So, as you said before, this is the first time you are using ROUVY application. Do you like its interface? I know some of the stages are in augmented reality, so you can look around too, if you want.
Yeah, I mean, I like it. It's new to me, you know, the cartoon avatars in the real life video, which I know, the roads I know. So it's pretty fun to do it and, you know, feel the gradient. I like it so far. Yeah.
You are in the first quarter of this climb towards Gorjanci. How do you think it will unfold for you?
Well, it's just, you know, for me, just riding the watts I enjoy today. So I guess I should stay in around this place or around, you know, 20 plus minus. I don't really care, but I'm going to try to enjoy it as much as possible. I do enjoy those false flats towards the top. Then you can put on a big chain ring. It's cool, like in real life.
That's right. Ali vidiš morda, Marko, kakšne prednosti v tem, recimo zdaj si se pripravljal na Tenerifih, da si lahko v bistvu iz svoje dnevne sobe na kateremkoli koncu sveta, recimo da preizkusiš RAM, bom zdaj rekel v narekovajih, odpeljati v dnevni sobi, da se morda na tak način pripraviš na dirko?
Ja, sigurno je prednost. Moram reči, da ni 100% na isto pripravljati se na indoorju, pa na trenerju sa mnom, ali pa zunaj. Težko pojasniti, pač ni. Tako da ampak je pa sigurno boljši kot nič, sploh pa s temi aplikacijami, kot je ROUVY, pa Zift in ostale, pač popestri zadevo, sploh recimo v lanskem letu, COVID leto, ne, ker veliko tudi nismo smeli ven, nekateri, v drugih državah še manj, no, mi smo vsaj po svojih občinah malo penetrali, tako da je res ful pomagano. Sploh, pa še kak je te terkice se doležiš, tudi group riding, prav, skupinske vožnje, virtualne. Zadeva pač popestri in sigurno tudi dvigne pripravljenost. Ni pa to čisto isto kot zunaj, tako da še zmer rabeš pol dodati tudi zunanje treninge.
Meanwhile, I think Jani is trying to bridge across the Bruce Bird, who is currently on the first place. But yeah, I think that in the minute he saw that he put big watts into his pedals too. So yeah, Marco, what about mental? Mental, I don't know, health and mentality. How do you go on such a long race knowing that you're gonna hurt?
Well, I think it all depends on the motivation. And there's not many, if any, motorcyclists that wouldn't be motivated, you know, to do what it was motivated to achieve their goals, our goals. So when you have that, I mean, that's all the motivation you need. That's all. All the mental preparation. Of course, experience helps with every longer race. You do a step up. You know, when I started, 12 hours was pretty big thing, you know, win in my racing career. Probably, yeah, and he says the same. The longest races, maybe trainings were longer, were 240 to 50 kilometers, which, you know, with a fast team, you can do it in 7-8 hours. So that was tops. And then when I started, 12 hours was, you know, you're scared of it. The first time, 24, even more. But when you do RAM, you know, it's 9 days of 20 plus hours cycling a day, and 24 hours, I won't say piece of cake, you know, but it's nothing to be afraid of anymore. So that's what this is, you know. It's just when you're motivated, you know, it's never a problem. For my crew, you know, you have the crew which supports you. It was never a question of me not trying to go on, even if I hurt a lot. I was sleepy, I was, you know, cranky. But when you see the finish line as a goal, you never question why. You just go on pedal. It is. I asked a guy what's the secret of RAM, and he said just sit on the bike and pedal. You can go on. That's it.
That's great. That's great. We saw. Meanwhile, we saw Jani Brajkovic, who is still on the second place, trying to bridge the gap towards Bruce Burt, who is who came on the split time. Just a second. Yeah.
He's over the top.
Yeah, he's over the top, yes. Tell me, Marco, how do you fuel yourself for such an event? You said before that you are a little bit cranky at the times, but is this because of the food, or this is because of everything?
I guess it's everything. Things start to hurt, you know, after a couple of days on a bike. Every part of the body which touches the bike hurts, so the hands, the feet, and the behind, of course, which usually is the most unbearable. So for nutrition, it is a really important part, because you need I can talk for myself, I need 300 to 400 calories an hour. Of course, I do burn more, and there's no way my stomach can handle more. But if I can do 300 is the minimum, then I'm happy, I can go on, and my crew is not worried. But even that can be a hard job sometimes, because after a few days, your taste buds are not functioning properly anymore. So all the food, especially, you know, that expensive sports nutrition that you always use, just loses the taste. You just don't find it anymore. So then the crew can or should get their resources together and try to find you some way to feed you, even if it means, you know, hamburgers or stuff. A normal cyclist or coach would say, get away from that, you know. But in ultra cycling, there's a saying, every calorie is a good calorie. So if I crave for a hamburger or milkshake during Ram, my crew will for sure make their best to try to get one for me.
That's great.
And they try to stay on top of it, you know, they write down my intake calories and the hydration so that you don't mess up. Because after a few days, I cannot think for myself anymore. Not that precisely. So yeah, it's a big part of the success in ultra cycling. Good crew and good nutrition.
That's great. Meanwhile, when we were talking, the first riders came through the split time, and yeah, on the third place is Julian Stephens, who won the first stage of IFIL Slovenia Virtual Tour of Slovenia. And yeah, as we were talking about nutrition, Frutobela after each stage presents the interesting data about our pro cyclists. And on the first stage, Matej Mohorič burned 218 calories and reached a max speed of almost 50 kilometers per hour. And between 8th and 12th March, you can participate in competition and predict how much calories will burn Domen Novak in third stage of IFIL Slovenia Virtual Tour of Slovenia. The prizes are great. It's a box of Frutabela bars and Team Bahrain Victorious Bidan. The race is really unfolding. Still on the second place is Jani Brajković, who is trying to bridge the gap. Let's see what Jani has to say. Jani, can you hear me?
Yes, the bird is flying.
seems like you are bridging very well now at the descent.
No, I'm not bridging. It's impossible. But anyways, it's fine.
It looks like that because Bruce is on this flat section. On the flat section, yes. So yeah, try to fly toward him, right?
I need a rocket, not a bird.
Do you have these problems on real roads too, on the descending because of your lightweight?
No, in real life it's different. Real life is real life.
Do you train descents on real roads at this stage this descent will be crucial. Do you try and train there or you just go with the flow?
You just go with the flow because, I mean, unless you have serious problems descending, then you have to focus on that. But otherwise, you just follow or you leap.
Okay. Yeah, and as we are talking about descending, Continental is the official tire of IFIL Slovenia Virtual Tour of Slovenia, and they will give 5 pairs of Grand Prix 5000 tires in their competition. Yeah, and one pair will be given out between third and fourth stage, and the prize question will be published on social profile of Tour of Slovenia at the Facebook and Instagram. Če gremo k etapam, kaj nas čaka v naslednji etapi? Naslednja etapa bo potekala od Izole do Kopra, 39 km bo dolga. Definitivno zanimiva etapa. Seveda pa, preden pridemo do naslednjega tedna, se mora končati druga etapa IFIL Slovenija, virtualne dirke po Sloveniji. na kateri zelo dobro kaže Bruce Burdu, ki je trenutno na prvem mestu, prevozil je že skoraj 35 km, na drugem mestu mu sledi Jani Brajkovič, ki trenutno za njim zaostaja 1,5 km. Ja, Bruce, res, kot je rekel Jani, leti proti cilju. Na tretjem mestu je Julian Stephens, ki je prejšnji teden na prvi etapi vzel v narekovajih krono na krvavcu za zmago etape. Tako da ja, definitivno nas čaka zanimiv konec, do katerega pa še bo, ja, do katerega nas loči še kar nekaj časa. Ko sem šel gledati rezultate tele trase na Ruviju, je zanimivo, da so najboljši časi ravno tu nekje pod 1:59:09, glavnina pa je nekje tam med 1:10. Ja, tako je. Marko, how is it going now?
Pretty good. I have a question now for you.
Yeah, tell me.
Mr. Bird, who is the first, is he by chance Canadian?
Oh, I wish I could see that.
I knew, he's gonna know.
Just a second. Yeah, he's Canadian. Yeah, that's right, that's right.
Okay, I know the guy.
Do you know Bruce?
You know, when 5-6 years ago we had a Masters World Championships in Ljubljana, you know, on the route of Marathon Franja, in September though, he was in my category, so we escaped together. He was first, I was second.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it
me.
Looks really good for him today to win the stage.
Yeah, I guess there's no way Jan with his kilos can catch him, because Bruce is probably 80 kilos, 80 plus, 82, for descents. You know, for the virtual descents, because like Jan said, in real life, the difference is not that big, but in the virtual world, they kind of exaggerate that weight for the downhill, so it's just, yeah, I guess it's really impossible for Jani, I don't know, 60 kilos to catch Bruce with 80. That would be a huge task. Yeah.
Marco, you will be at the top in almost no time. You're doing great.
I feel good.
You are currently at the 47th place. So yeah.
The climbing in Tenerife did me some good.
Did you some good. That's great.
Yeah, I think we did 38,000 meters of climbing in 2 weeks. Pretty crazy number.
That's a lot. So tell me. Do you go, you said that you go on Tenerife or on the islands one time a year. What is your next destination? What is your, I don't know, wish to, country?
Well, the wish
where you
is, well, I haven't been to USA in more than a year because of COVID. So I have one thing that should really happen is the 24-hour World Championships, which is only in October, so I'm just praying, hoping that we can travel by then. Otherwise, there was this training camp I was planning last year in Borrego Springs in California, so we postponed it for this May, but it still doesn't look very good because it's still not possible to fly to USA, so let's see. I keep my fingers crossed at least for the World Champs. Yeah, there's another race on my calendar in mid-May. There's 500 miles in Ireland, which I hope I can manage. I mean, I can manage to travel there. I shall see. I'm hopeful. You know, you have to keep your goals, because otherwise the motivation for training is zero. So
that's correct. That's correct.
That's it.
What about Race Across America? Is this story, I don't know, closed, ended, or do you, I don't know, wish to go there?
Not for me.
Too again. Yeah, for you. That's the for you, of course.
Yeah, I mean, I still feel I can do a result. I mean, I can feel a little bit of decline, but just on the high, on the top end power, which you really don't need in ultra cycling a lot. So yeah, there's a, I mean, I would say so. I can be happy with what I did. And live my normal life. And for now, the goal for those big races, the primary goal is the Siberia, Red Bull Trans-Siberian Extreme. But after that, I can imagine myself going back. Of course, it all depends on the sponsorship, and because that's, those races are really, really expensive. So I would say that I didn't say no to going back to Ram yet. There's still a wish that's burning. I have the record. The last time I did it in 2019, I set the record for 50 plus years. And of course I can improve that. At least that.
That's great.
And I was still second in general classification, so I was pretty close to the guy, I mean, the closest to the guy who won. So we shall see, but never say no. I think I'm more likely to go back than no.
Oh, great, great. So yeah, we are talking about traveling and everything. Yeah, what would you say to a cyclist or a non-cyclist who would like to travel to Slovenia? How would you invite him to try cycle in Slovenia?
Yeah, it's probably one of the best places in the world. I mean, you listen to me talking about how great Canary Islands are, California and stuff. It is, you know, mostly because you change scenery a little bit. And for Canaries or the warm places in the winter, you know, the Slovenia is still middle of Slovenia. Still a little bit cold to do long training rides in the winter. So that's why we like to go to warm places. But otherwise, Slovenia is, we like to call it pocket country, you know, around by the border, which used to be race around Slovenia, is 1,000 kilometers or so, 1,200 kilometers. So we have everything. We have Alps, so the passes, we have a seaside. So for us, I mean, in Ljubljana, in the middle of Slovenia, it's perfect. We can go climbing on the passes. We can go swimming in the sea or in the winter, training by the seaside. And we have races also. We organize 24-hour, this year, European Championships in Dubrovnik, and 12 hours, and also a race around Slovenia, which now is called the Slovenia Ultra, 800 kilometers, 850 kilometers long, which should this year take place in September. So, I mean, yeah, you should come and check it out. I mean, the roads are more or less great. I mean, of course, we have some bad ones, but the drivers are, you know, all around the world is the same. You have some people who don't like us cyclists. The same here, but I think with last year, with the success of...
Pardon, Marko.
Sorry. Yeah.
Ja, da te prekinjam.
Oh, it's
Bruce,
yeah, okay.
Je prišel v cilj. Ja, oziroma right. Prihaja v cilj, tako je.
Right.
So yeah, as the Marko was talking, Bruce Burt took first place in this second stage of IFIL Slovenia, Virtual Tour of Slovenia. As it looks, Jani and Julian are gonna, I don't know, maybe sprint for a second place if Julian catches Jani. Let's see how Jani is doing. Jani, everything okay?
No. Don't talk to me right now.
Okay, okay. We're just gonna look. So good luck, good luck.
Yeah.
Takole, Jani, se približuje cilju. Prišel je v zadnji kilometer, Julian Stephens se mu približuje na tretje mesto je trenutno. Mislim tudi, da ja, ne vidi še Janija, tako da držimo pesti, da Jani zasede drugo mesto. Marko, med tem, ko Jani kolesari proti cilju, sva se pogovarjala sicer v angleščini, kako bi povabil kolesarje kolesariti ali pa nasplošno turiste kolesariti v Slovenijo. Kaj pa bi rekel Slovencem, recimo, ko potuješ okrog, prideš nazaj v Slovenijo, kaj bi jim rekel recimo za ostale kraje ali pa v primerjavi s Slovenijo?
Ja, moram reči, da Slovenci se ne zvedamo, koliko bi držali živimo. No. Dokaj ne rešeno, ne pravijo. Amerika, obljubljena država, pa ne vem kaj, raj. Jaz ne fulžati, ja. Tudi ful dobre prijatelje tam. Ampak se še raj vrnem. Res. Tako da, ja ne vem, jaz bi... Probajte si ogledati Slovenci tudi to je naša mehna država z kolesa, ker je precej drugačka iz avta. Pa tudi tisti, ki se mogoče ne sedete na kolo. Probajte biti obzirni za kolesarjev. Te moram reči, da to sem bih prej v angleščini govoril, da se zadeva vse mogoče. Večno zboljšuje, ne, verjetno tudi po zaslugi tedaja in Primoža, tudi Franca in vsega tega. Ne. Ampak še zmer najdeš ne samo v Sloveniji, to sod. Nažalost najdeš ljudi v avtih, ki mislijo, da so ceste samo za njih. Zelo, da je treba včasih kolesarja z rim. Tako da pomisliti je treba, no, da sam piskaj na kolesoma, doma imamo početa pa nekateri žene, sinove, ščerke. Tako da lahko kar precej škodem z tistim dvem ponama, ne, s katerimi se prevažaš okoli. Tako da,
res je.
To je prvo. No.
Superca, superca. Zdaj Lik med tem je... Ja, med tem, ko se pogovarjava, je Jani tudi prišel v cilj kot drugi. Upam, da je že prišel do sape. Jani, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, did you catch your breath?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, second place. That's great, right?
It's fun, yes.
Were you hoping to take the stage?
No, I didn't. Actually, I didn't know what to expect because I've never raced on this platform, so I didn't really know how everything works. So in the beginning, I was a little bit surprised because usually on the road outdoors, when you're putting 6.5 watts per kilo, there's no way you get dropped on the flats, but it's a little bit different here. So yeah, I just need some time to adjust to the platform, and then I'm pretty sure that things will be better.
That's great. So yeah, this was a virtual stage. But what would you say to a cyclist or non-cyclist who thinks about visiting our country?
Call me. I'll show you around.
Okay. That's great. Jani, thank you. Thank you for today's participation, and all good in this season as a coach or as a cyclist.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
To me too. Marco, can you hear me?
Yeah, Sesham. I can hear you.
Yeah, that's great. So yeah, Marco, thank you for today's company. I hope you enjoy it as much as I did. I know I was just sitting here in a comfortable chair, but it didn't look too hard for you.
That was fine. I enjoyed seeing the old roads again, and especially I can see a lot of cracks in the roads, and you actually cannot feel it on the virtual platform. So it was a pleasure. It was fun. Thanks for inviting me.
Yeah, of course, no problem. So, how much time will you spend now in Slovenia before you are traveling again? Do you have some itinerary or something?
Nothing much. I mean, like I said, in theory, I should have a camp in California in second part of April, which seems very unlikely now. After that, Ireland race on 15th of May, and then in June, Moscow, so Trans-Siberian race.
If that's great.
If not, we'll find some replacement race for sure.
Yeah, Marco, thank you again, and I hope we catch each other in some I don't know, coffee house or something.
For coffee. Okay.
Yeah, that's right. have a good time.
When they open the coffee shops. Okay, thanks.
That's right.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. As the participants are going through the finish line, let me just say that today was the second stage of IFIL Slovenia Virtual Tour of Slovenia. It took place from Črnomelj to Novo Mesto in a length of 42 kilometers. It was 457 participants, 457 cyclists from 43 countries, if I'm correct. And the first place took Bruce Burt, and on the second place was Jani Brajkovic, our pro cyclist. On the third place was Julian Stephens, who took the KOM on the first stage to Krvavec. Let's see the other participants who are driving towards the finish line. Takole, kot lahko vidimo, kolesarji se vozijo proti cilju. Tukaj sedaj vidim, da na 18. mestu tudi Andrej Žalbi, ki sva ga z Bogdanom omenila že v prvi etapi IFIL Slovenija virtualne dirke po Sloveniji. Danes je zmagal Bruce Burt iz Kanade, na drugem mestu je Jani Brajkovič in na tretjem Julian Stephens, ki je prejšnji teden vzel krono na Krvavcu, torej bil zmagovalec prve etape. V tretji etapi pa nas čaka vožnja od Izole preko Šmarja pa do Kopra v dolžini 39 km. Tako, tole bi bilo z moje strani vse. Slišimo in vidimo se ponovno prihodnjo soboto ob 19. uri na istem mestu kot do sedaj. So yeah, this was all from me today. We see each other next Saturday at the same time at 19 o'clock, and we'll see each other, and pedal hard until then. Bye bye.
Frutabela spodbuja dobre navade.
Riding or driving, feel confident with Continental.
Cestno kolo Vondrist 2959,99 evrov servis.